So hi everyone and a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. In this session, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. And I hope aap sabko ab tak mein pata chal gaya hoga that RBI notification is now out. So it's time that you should gear up your preparation. Ab apna time waste mat karo. And it is for the very first time, aisa hua hai ki RBI ne 2 mahine se zyada diye hain for phase 1. अभी आपके पास नोटिफिकेशन की जानकारी ऑलरेडी आ चुकी है एंड टुडे इज 23rd मार्च एंड द फेज वन इज ऑन 28th मई. तो बहुत ही लंबा टाइम है इस लंबे टाइम में, और फेज टू की अगर हम बात करें तो 3 महीने. इन 3 महीने में बहुत अच्छे से प्रिपरेशन की जा सकती है. तो जो भी टाइम टेबल आपको अनुज सर ने बताया है प्लीज फॉलो दैट, जो भी स्ट्रैटेजी बताई है प्लीज फॉलो दैट एंड जस्ट फोकस ऑन द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एग्जाम नाउ. बाकी सारी चीजें छोड़ दो, अगर कोई वेब सीरीज चल रही थी वो छोड़ दो, अगर कहीं किसी के साथ घूमने जाना था वो छोड़ दो, सारे प्लान्स छोड़ दो. ये 3 महीने डेडिकेटेडली सिर्फ आपको आरबीआई ग्रेड बी प्रिपरेशन को देने चाहिए. ऑलराइट, एंड लेट्स बिगिन विद टुडे सेशन. एंड बिफोर वी बिगिन लेट मी टेल यू, इफ यू वांट टू हैव एन ऑल राउंड प्रिपरेशन एट वन स्टॉप देन यू शुड डाउनलोड दिस ऐप. इस ऐप में यू विल गेट डेली जीके एंड क्विजेस, ऑल द एग्जाम अपडेट्स, टॉपर स्ट्रेटजीज, लाइव सेशंस जो यूट्यूब पे कंडक्ट होते हैं वो वहां पे आपको मिल जाएंगे. So it is a one-stop solution for all your exam-related things. Okay, everything is provided here. So go to the Play Store and download this app now. All right, and you can follow me here for anything related to examination. All right, so let's begin with very first question. And guys, today's session is very, very important. There are 3-4 schemes in it, which we have never studied in the past. In fact, they have never come in the news before. Okay, but now they are in news. So today's session is very important. So let's talk about the very first question. Consider the following statements with respect to scheme for rehabilitation of bonded laborers, and you have to identify the correct statement. This is not a new scheme. Jo bhi scheme hum aaj padhenge usme se koi bhi scheme nayi scheme nahi hai. All schemes are already under implementation, but they are in news and that's why we are discussing it. All right, so this question is regarding scheme for rehabilitation of bonded laborers. Let's talk about this scheme. So remember, Ministry of Labour and Employment. Now can you tell me who is the Minister of Labour and Employment? Write down in the comments. मैंने कई बार आप लोगों को बताया है ministers के नाम. Write down in the comments the name of Minister of Labour and Employment. So this ministry is implementing the scheme for rehabilitation for bonded labourers. Now let's talk about this scheme. First of all, what is the objective? Objective क्या है इस scheme का? So as I told you so many times that the objective of any scheme can be extracted from its name itself. All right, so what is the name? Scheme for rehabilitation of bonded laborers, which means this scheme is intended towards rehabilitation of the bonded laborers. All right, but ek cheez aapko yaad rakhni padegi yahan pe, that this rehabilitation is in the form of cash assistance. All right, so objective is to provide cash rehabilitation assistance to the bonded laborers. Okay, it was launched in the year 1978 as centrally sponsored scheme, but in the month of May 2016 it was relaunched, it was revamped as a central sector scheme. ठीक है, इसको दोबारा से लॉन्च किया गया 2016 में as central sector scheme, and now in the year 2022 it has been extended till the financial year 2025 as revamped central scheme for rehabilitation of bonded laborers. So basically, if anyone asks you what is the launch year of the scheme, the answer would be 1978. All right, and in the 2022 it has been extended up to financial year 2026 as revamped central sector scheme for rehabilitation of bonded labor. But please remember this, that in the year 1978 it was launched as centrally sponsored scheme, but now it is a central sector scheme, which means entire funding is borne by the central government only. State government ko koi paisa nahi dena hota is scheme mein. All right, moving ahead, so what type of rehabilitation assistance is provided? If the beneficiary is a male, if the beneficiary is a male bonded labor, then rupees 1 lakh per adult is provided by the central government. If the beneficiary belongs to any special category, like for example, if the beneficiary is an orphan child, if he is a rescued child and woman, then in that case this cash assistance is how much? Rupees 2 lakh. Tab kitna hai? 2 lakh rupees hai agar कोई स्पेशल कैटेगरी का बेनिफिशियरी है तो. एंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ स्पेशल कैटेगरी बेनिफिशियरी? एनी ऑर्फन चाइल्ड, एनी रेस्क्यूड चाइल्ड एंड वुमेन. ऑलराइट, And remember, out of this rupees 2 lakh, 1.25 lakh will be invested in annuity in the name of beneficiary, and the rest 75,000 will be transferred to the beneficiary's account in DBT format. Okay. If there is a case of bonded or forced labor involving extreme cases, अब extreme cases का मतलब क्या है यहाँ पे कि any woman which is rescued from any brothel, या कोई human trafficking का case है, या फिर कोई और extreme case है, so in that case this financial assistance, this rehabilitation assistance is rupees 3 lakhs, and out of this rupees 3 lakh, 2 lakh will be invested in the annuity in the name of beneficiary, and the rest 1 lakh will be transferred to the beneficiary's account through DBT mode, alright? And as I already told you, the state government shall not provide anything. किसी भी तरीके का कोई contribution state government का नहीं होता, because it is a central sector scheme. Alright, I hope this is clear. Now, there is one more provision here, a bonded labor rehabilitation fund. A bonded labor rehabilitation fund shall be created by all the states at district level with a permanent corpus of rupees 10 lakh. So permanent corpus कितना होगा? 10 lakh होगा. Now, what is the objective of this separate fund? This is a separate fund, bonded labor rehabilitation fund at district level. The objective of this fund is to extend the immediate financial assistance to the rescued bonded labor. अगर कोई bonded labor को rescue किया गया है, तो उसको immediate financial assistance की ज़रूरत पड़ती है. So in that case, इस fund में से पैसा निकाला जाएगा. And the authority, the responsibility of extending this immediate financial assistance lies with the district magistrate of the district. And up to maximum 30,000 can be provided by the district magistrate. कितना मिल सकता है? 30,000 रुपये मिल सकता है, उससे ज़्यादा नहीं. अगर उससे ज़्यादा देना है तो उसमें सेटिस्फैक्शन ज़रूरी है किसकी? डीएम की. ठीक है, डीएम की सेटिस्फैक्शन ज़रूरी है, तो ये 30,000 से ज़्यादा भी हो सकता है. Alright? And finally, there is a provision of conducting survey and generating awareness campaigns under this particular scheme. And do remember, जो ये survey का और awareness का खर्चा होगा, the expenditure related to survey and awareness, in that expenditure, central government will provide up to 50% of the expenditure incurred. ठीक है? Central government कितना देगा? Up to 50%, up to maximum 50% of the total expenditure incurred in these awareness generation programs and in conducting survey. Right? So this was about the scheme, and now let's come back to the question. Here you have to identify, the correct statement. Yes, so there are three statements here. The scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So please don't get confused. There can be confusion between this Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment and Ministry of Labour and Employment, because here we are talking about rehabilitation of bonded labour. So yahan pe confusion ho sakti hai. So please yaad rakhe that this scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Labour and Employment only. It was launched in 1919. Is that so? नहीं, अभी हमने पढ़ा, इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 1978. इट इज अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम विद 50-50 फाइनेंशियल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन फ्रॉम सेंटर एंड स्टेट. इट वॉज अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम व्हेन इट वॉज लॉन्च, बट नाउ द करंट सिचुएशन इज दैट इट इज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम. ओके, सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर इनकरेक्ट हियर, व्हिच मींस ऑप्शन डी, नन इज करेक्ट, शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. Question number 2. Yes, what is the launch year of National Child Labour Project scheme for rehabilitation of child labourers? Now, this scheme is about the rehabilitation of the child labourers. The earlier scheme was for the rehabilitation of bonded labourers, while this is for the child labourers, which is being implemented by, again, Ministry of Labour and Employment. Alright, so let's talk about this scheme then. And let me tell you, it is also not a new scheme. It is under implementation in the year 1988. It was launched way back in the year 1988. It is already under implementation by the Ministry of Labour and Employment. But we are discussing it because it is in news, and it is a very important scheme, because it is directly related to your economic and social issues part. जिसमें भी social issues वाला जो part है, उससे directly relate करता है. All right. Now let's talk about this. So objective is very clear, as the name suggests. It is a scheme for rehabilitation of child laborers, and child laborers in the age group of 9 to 14 years. So basically, to rescue minor child in the age group of 9 to 14 years from work is the objective of the scheme. And after rescuing them, the objective is also to enroll them in the NCLP special training center. What is this NCLP? दिस इज नेशनल चाइल्ड लेबर प्रोजेक्ट, ठीक है, नेशनल चाइल्ड लेबर प्रोजेक्ट, पूरा नाम इसका यही है, नेशनल चाइल्ड लेबर प्रोजेक्ट स्कीम फॉर रिहैबिलिटेशन ऑफ चाइल्ड लेबरर्स, राइट। तो आफ्टर रेस्क्यूइंग द चाइल्ड द स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर्स, तो उनको स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर्स में भेजा जाता है, एंड इन दीज स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर्स ऑफ एनसीएलपी वेरियस टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग्स आर प्रोवाइडेड टू द रेस्क्यूड चाइल्ड, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल ब्रिज एजुकेशन, वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग, मिड डे मील, स्टाइपेंड, हेल्थ केयर, एवरीथिंग इज प्रोवाइडेड, ठीक है। एंड आफ्टर दैट, ठीक है, आफ्टर ये जो स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर है इसमें कुछ टाइम के रहने के बाद द चाइल्ड आर मेनस्ट्रीम इनटू फॉर्मल एजुकेशन सिस्टम, ठीक है, आफ्टर स्पेंडिंग सम टाइम इन द एनसीएलपी स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर्स द चिल्ड्रन आर मेनस्ट्रीम इनटू द फॉर्मल एजुकेशन सिस्टम, ऑलराइट। सो बेसिकली द अल्टीमेट ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम इज टू रेस्क्यू अ चाइल्ड फ्रॉम द बॉन्डेड लेबर एंड टू कनेक्ट हिम विद द फॉर्मल एजुकेशन सिस्टम ऑफ द कंट्री, ऑलराइट। But remember, this NCLP scheme has now been subsumed under समग्र शिक्षा अभियान। समग्र शिक्षा अभियान, I hope आप सबको पता होगा, हमने पहले कई बार पढ़ा है, और अगर आपने नहीं पढ़ा है तो you can go to the playlist of government scheme, there you can find this scheme, alright। So it is currently under समग्र शिक्षा अभियान, alright। Talking more about this scheme, it is a central sector scheme, which means entire funding is borne by the central government only, there is no contribution from state government side, and Ministry of Labour and Employment provides grant in aid to district project society. Ministry of Labour and Employment क्या करता है? District project society को पैसे देता है, which provides that grant to the concerned implementing agencies for the operation of this particular scheme. All right. And as I already told you, it was launched in the year 1988. Okay. Now, so let's come back to the question then. The question is regarding just the launch year. Very easy question then. It was launched in the year 1988. Option B is the correct answer to this question. All right, let's move ahead to question number 3, which is again based on a scheme. However, this scheme is not that important, and that's why we will not discuss this scheme in very much detail. So, इसको ऊपर ऊपर से ही देखेंगे क्योंकि बहुत ज़्यादा important नहीं है. The question is, what is the quantum of funding per year for an organization under scheme of financial assistance for the preservation and development of cultural heritage of the Himalayas. तो बहुत ही लंबा नाम है स्कीम का, बट इस लंबे नाम से बहुत सारी चीजें क्लियर हैं. From the name itself, the objective is clear, the ministry is clear, because they are talking about cultural heritage, which means the ministry should be the ministry of culture. They are talking about preservation and development of cultural heritage of Himalaya. So this must be objective of the scheme. So two things are already mentioned in the name of the scheme itself. All right. So let's talk about this scheme. So Ministry of Culture is implementing this scheme, and objective is to promote, protect and preserve the cultural heritage of Himalayan region, spreading in the union territories of Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. So in these states and UTs, this scheme is being implemented to protect, conserve and preserve the cultural heritage of the Himalayan region. Ministry clear है, Ministry of Culture है, and this protection, promotion and preservation is being done through research, documentation and dissemination of information to all the stakeholders. All right. Moving ahead, financial assistance, remember, under this scheme is provided to the voluntary organizations. मतलब there is no direct funding to the state governments. ठीक है, which means, do remember again, it is a central sector scheme. It is a central sector scheme in which there is no contribution from the state government side. Entire funding is contributed from the central government, and there is no provision of providing funding directly to the states. In fact, the funding is provided to the voluntary organizations which are being implementing this scheme. Okay? Which are implementing this scheme. Then, the quantum of funding is rupees 10 lakh per year for an organization. Ek organization ko maximum kitna milta hai? 10 lakh rupay, but Expert Advisory Committee can extend this amount beyond 10 lakh also, but up to maximum rupees 30 lakh. ठीक है, वैसे कितना है provision? 10 lakh per year for an organization, but एक Expert Advisory Committee है जो कि 10 lakh से ऊपर लेके जा सकती है, but up to maximum of 30 lakh. Alright. तो इतना ही पढ़ेंगे, there is no need to go into more details of this scheme. Alright. So, now let's come back to the question. You have to find out the quantum of funding per year. So quantum of funding per year is rupees 10 lakh. 30 lakh is the maximum amount, and that is that too on the recommendation of expert advisory committee. Okay, so if they are asking you the quantum of funding per year, the answer would be 10 lakh only. But if they are asking you what is the maximum amount that can be given under this scheme, then in that case the answer would be rupees 30 lakh. Okay. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. At which IIT Professor K. Vijay Raghavan, who is the principal scientific advisor to the Government of India, has inaugurated the new water management and policy center, which is named as AquaMap. ठीक है, सो ये एक नया वाटर मैनेजमेंट सेंटर और पॉलिसी वाटर मैनेजमेंट और पॉलिसी सेंटर है, AquaMap इसका नाम है, इनॉग्रेटेड बाय प्रोफेसर के विजय राघवन. तो कहाँ पे, कौन से IIT में इसको इनॉग्रेट किया? तो रिमेंबर, इट हैज बीन इनॉग्रेटेड बाय द प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर एट IIT मद्रास. कहाँ पे? IIT मद्रास में. एंड रिमेंबर, दिस AquaMap इज एम्ड एट प्रोवाइडिंग सोल्यूशंस फॉर कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड चैलेंजिंग वाटर प्रॉब्लम्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री. And this will be done by designing and evolving smart and optimal water management practices. All right. It is a national water center, जो कि इसके already mentioned है यहाँ पे. And IIT Madras for this is collaborating with IIT Dharwad around the broad theme of data science for water security and agriculture sustenance. This is not important for the exam. ठीक है, just remember that AquaMap has been inaugurated by Professor K. Vijay Raghavan at IIT Madras. Which is nothing but a water management policy center. Okay. So therefore, the correct answer is what? Correct answer will be IIT Madras, option B. Okay. Now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is again based on a scheme, very very important scheme. Consider the following statements with respect to Nayi Roshni scheme, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Now, remember, the scheme is being implemented by the Ministry of Minority Affairs, headed by Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, and it is already under implementation since the year 2012-13. But since it is in news, and that's why we are discussing it. So, what is the objective of this scheme? To empower and enhance confidence in minority women. First of all, please focus that this scheme is not for all women; it is for minority women only. Okay? So, to instill confidence in minority women by providing knowledge, tool, and techniques. For leadership development, and if you want to have an overall idea of this scheme, then just remember that this Nayi Roshni scheme is to provide, is to instill the leadership confidence among the minority women. ठीक है, उनके अंदर confidence देना ताकि उनके अंदर की leadership को develop किया जा सके. Okay. It was launched in 2012-13, as I already told you. It is, remember, a 6 days non-residential or 5 days residential training program under which the leadership training is provided to the minority women. The age group, what should be the age group? 18 years to 65 years ki koi bhi minority women hai to unko beneficiary banaya ja sakta hai under this particular scheme. And training, what type of training they are providing? Related to health and hygiene, legal rights of women, financial literacy, digital literacy, Swachh Bharat, life skills, etc., etc., behavior skills, ye sari cheeze unko is tarike ki training provide karai jati hai. All right. And now you have to identify the incorrect statement. It was launched in 2014. No, that was 2012-13 when it was launched. Minority women between age 18 and 65 are eligible. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is being implemented by Ministry of Women and Child Development. So again, there can be confusion between the Ministry of Women and Child Development and Minority Affairs. But please don't do so. प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट Nayi Roshni, देखो जितनी भी स्कीम नई वर्ड से शुरू हो रहे हैं या नया वर्ड से शुरू हो रहे हैं, ठीक है, ये याद रख लो, एक छोटी सी ट्रिक है. एनी स्कीम स्टार्टिंग विद द वर्ड नई और नया आर बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ माइनॉरिटी अफेयर्स होंगी टिल नाउ. आगे कुछ चेंज हो जाए तो आई डोंट नो. सो हियर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन सी, ओनली 1 and 3 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. And now let's talk about question number 6, which is the 1 marker question. ठीक है, direct question है, इसमें ज़्यादा detail में नहीं जाएंगे और ज़रूरत ही नहीं है detail में जाने की. बहुत interesting question है. How much percent of their gross budgetary support the central ministries or departments are mandated to spend for central sector and centrally sponsored scheme in northeast region? मतलब basically central ministries और departments जो है उनकी जो central sector या फिर centrally sponsored scheme में जो total खर्चा होता है उसका कितना परसेंट नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन में होना चाहिए, ठीक है। तो दिस परसेंटेज गाइज रिमेंबर इज 10%, ऑप्शन ए 10% इज द करेक्ट आंसर। अगर ये पढ़ा हुआ नहीं होगा और एग्जाम में आ गया तो ये, और ये ऐसी चीज है जो आपको हर जगह नहीं मिलेगी, ठीक है। सो याद रखना 10% ऑफ द ग्रॉस बजटरी सपोर्ट मिनिस्ट्री और डिपार्टमेंट्स को स्पेंड करना होता है कहाँ पे, नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन में विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम एंड द सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम। ओके, सो ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर। एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फाउंडेशन हैज और हैव ऑर्गेनाइज्ड अक्ष लेसन्स फ्रॉम इंडिया टू टेक की लेसन्स एंड शेयर एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस फ्रॉम इंडियाज कोविड मैनेजमेंट। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो, इन दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूज, नथिंग इज इंपॉर्टेंट बिसाइड दिस। दे आर ओनली गोइंग टू आस्क द नेम ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सिर्फ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का नाम पूछा जाएगा, नथिंग मोर देन दैट। एंड हो सकता है कि इस इवेंट का नाम पूछ लिया जाए, तो डू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दिस इवेंट ऑल्सो, अक्ष, ठीक है। तो दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन गाइज इज बिल एंड मिलिंडा गेट्स फाउंडेशन, ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर। Alright, and that's it for the session today. And if you want to have the PDF of this session, please join the Telegram channel. And iska link aapko description mein mil jayega. Alright. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next session on Friday. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.